Hello, Mr. Arian, I'm a lecturer in metallurgy. I teach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. So, for me, there is one God. In one God, we have one faith called Deen. There is no two God or two Deen. So, especially blind people have interfaith. Whereas the spiritually alive, they have one God, one faith. And I have written a book on this subject, and also first Gnostic principle, one God, one faith. But these people going to the church and other things, they have been told that the Gnostics are heretic. Because we preach the gospel truth, which is bitter. And these church people, don't call a priest, to get rid of them, Jesus died on the cross. They give them sugar-coated sermon of falsehoods. And then they have sectarian rites and all that trouble. Whereas the religion does not teach you to fight with each other, to love each other. So very few people love to know the gospel truth. And now at the end time, the Jewish people, most of them are fake sons of Abraham. They are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. These Jewish people were very clever. So they in the temple created a wall. They put a wall. In front was sitting the chosen people with stiff neck and put on all that gadget on the ear, head and everything, and you can see them today. And the people who came to visit the holiest of holy complex in the world was Jerusalem. And they were sitting behind. So anyone who wanted to say, I want to sit there and sing, you know, as they are singing. They were giving lip service. Then the priest will say, no problem. Get yourself circumcised and we will let you sit there. So circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the seed of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. They try to make circumcision compulsory in the churches. But there was St. Paul said, this circumcision is no good now. It is the circumcision of your heart which is more important. Heart with God. Circumcision, Son of God. So they stop there, but when they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, you know, the people of Ishmael, they had the morality and people of Isaac had the spirituality. People of Ishmael, they always honored people of Isaac for their spirituality. So first, Muhammad Sahib said, wherever you find a Jew, kill him. Because they were the one who killed apostles. They put them before animals to be eaten alive. They were so cruel. Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45 was fulfilled in them. But with the humbleness, they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib. And as they had the spiritual knowledge, so they soon became mullahs and other things. And then they propagated their own circumcision and kosher, which is halal. And our Father God has no son. And that is what they say, Allah has no son. I am the son of Allah. Al-Hanak. So, Mansur said, Al-Hanak, and they killed him, Mullah. So that time has passed now. Pope was killing people. Now is the time to preach gospel from the rooftop without fear of being killed. So, unless you preach gospel from the rooftop, you won't have peace of mind or live peacefully. You will be involved in sectarian riots and get killed. So here something I have written, I will explain as I go through. And my father had this knowledge. So 2,000 people came to attack our village, but when my father told them that we tribal people going to kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self. So the headman understood it, and he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, and which they did in Allah. That is the power of the gospel. If you want to live in peace, so preach gospel and not go by what these mullahs or rabbis or other people say. They are blind guides of the blind. They are Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, Satan of the highest power. So the blasphemers rule the world and you seek peace. Blasphemers are those what is inside is different from what they say from their mouth. Nathaniel, he was true Israelite, mean true son of Abraham. Like Joseph, he was speaking the gospel truth. What was inside was outside, no duplicity. Such are the people our father likes, and not those who are hypocrites. Tony Blair and Bush said that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction and they destroy the country and one military major general who is running a ministry, a Christian ministry, and he visited, he was there in Iraq after the destruction. And he came to Reading to give a sermon, and people asked him, did Saddam Hussein have weapon of mass destruction? He said, none at all. So this is called blasphemy. And so these Tony Blair and Bush, they were the greatest blasphemers you can come across. Like Anias and Safira, Peter killed them. But they are the war criminals, grooming freely. Because most of the people are sons of the Satan. They worship in Church of England, headed by Queen, she died. And now they had to change. But our head of Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, one fold, one shepherd. He is eternal. And so are the people, brethren in the Church of God, who preach gospel from the rooftop. They are eternal, like their anointed bridegroom, Christ Jesus. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And that's why I can tell you many things which are deeper than what these doctrinal priests know. But they, you know, hate me. They throw me out of the seminars and they call me heretic in the church and so. But never mind. Truth is truth. Nobody can fight against truth. So here is something which I have written. So read Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. The parable of wheat, the tribal sons of man, 144,000. They are all mentioned by the tribe, 12,000 of Judah tribe, Levi tribe, and so. Not as Jews. That would be saved. And here is the simple way to explain. And here you have This is under Adam. Under Adam you have races. Under races you have tribes. So the planet Earth is inhabited, habited by the sons of Adam, the tribal people. That's why 144,000 that will be saved. There's no Jew or Hindu or Sikh over here. They are under God, spiritual. Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. They are never born, they never die. Because they are spiritual. This is physical. People of Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, they were born, they died during the Holocaust, led by their blind guide. When a blind guide leads the blind, they fall into the pits of Holocaust. And that is what is happened in India also in 1947. The Stanic people, they knew it. They did it knowingly. And divided the country on the basis of Hindu, Sikh and Muslim, which are spiritual selves. Country does not belong to the religious people. Country does not belong to Hindu, Sikh or Muslim or Christian, but to the tribal people, to the sons of Adam. They can live in peace. Such people are found in Russia. Uzbekistan belong to Uzbek tribe, Tajikistan to Tajik tribe. So all countries are based upon tribe. Afghanistan belongs to Afghan tribe, not to Muslim, or Talmudim. So they are sons of the Most High Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, which is very powerful. And Abraham has demonstrated everything very clearly. But the people, they keep their own praises, and so they do things opposite what have been told by Abraham. So here is the, Yes, these things are in my description, or you can find on our website. So this Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, exploiting people in the name of religion, brotherhood, Muslim brotherhood, Christian brotherhood, Hindu brotherhood, Sikh brotherhood, all sons of the Most High Satan. To fight this one, you have to expose them. The exposure is through his word, or thinking logically, that people of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, they were born and they will die during any fighting or anything, or Holocaust. Not Jew. So not a single Jew died during Holocaust, or Hindu or Sikh or Muslim died in 1947, our sectarian riots in India, but the tribal people died. My father had this knowledge. With the knowledge of this one, 2,000 people of this type, fanatic, they came to attack our village. Fortunately, the headman of the party was friend of my uncle. So my father went with him, two of them, and he was sitting very proudly that we have the Pakistan. And when my father told him that we tribal people going to kill each other, Muslim and Sikh, they are spiritual self, not physical self. And he understood it, and my father explained the three sons of the Satan, Most High Satan, Lala Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, which the people call him Mahatma or Saint, and Lala Tara Singh Malhotra Khatri, and Lala Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Babla Patia, whom the people call him Qadi-e-Azam. They give him such a big, big title. You can well imagine how many people know the gospel truth. How many people can expose them? Hardly one in a thousand or one in a million in India. So don't be worried. Gospel truth is bitter for them. And they will object to my video. And they get them removed from YouTube. And I get a strike for expressing the gospel truth. So our Father knows better. So this 144,000 that would be saved, they are all tribal people. And tears are the sons of the most powerful Satan, Al-Djmar, Al-Aksa, Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, etc., of appearances, outwardly, and not of heart, spiritual, inwardly. So President Morsi was the latest, you know, son of the Most High Satan here, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. But the people of Ishmael, they worship Adam. So when Jesus, baby Jesus was born, then the people, the Jewish people wanted to kill him in collusion with the Roman emperor. So that's why the angel took baby Jesus and mother and father, foster father, surrogate mother and foster father to Egypt for the under the safety of Ishmael. And that's why the people of Ishmael, they honor their elders. They are the salt of the earth. I can tell much more about them. However, to say that they are still salt of the earth, they still honor the tribal people. And that's why they put Morsi in jail. Although he won the election, he was the president of Egypt. They put him in jail, and in jail he died. So this is a great lesson to the people that this planet is for the habitation of the tribal people, not the sons of Satan, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, or Christian. So now this promised land belongs to Abraham and his faithful sons, who can build their covenant with his real naughty son Isaac. Remember that Jacob had 12 sons, and out of 12 only Joseph was sort of Abraham, or sort of Isaac and Abraham. The other 11, they were liars and they were murderers, they were crook. So when they sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptians, there was none left behind who was faithful to Abraham. Now Abraham is the father of the faithful only, not of the unfaithful. So they had no right to live in that promised land because they were unfaithful and they were kicked out by Abraham and Yahweh who bring them over. No rain, out of hunger, they have to leave the country to Egypt. The Egyptian people honored them when they went there because Joseph was the prime minister over there. And they were given the best land in Egypt to settle. But again, the old habit died hard. They start cheating people. They started fleecing them. And when the local people found they are not good, trustworthy people, so they made them slaves and maltreated them. So much so that the food given to the swine, they were they were looking forward to that, to eat that one. And then they came into their senses that in our father's house we were having lush green field and all that. Then Moses brought them back, faithful sons of Abraham, and the same land then became lush green. Moses himself did not accompany them. Otherwise they would say, it is the miracle of Moses. No. It is the faithful sons. Land belongs to the faithful sons. The faithful sons, 6 days, they were singing that this land belonged to us. On seventh day they entered it peacefully. They did not kill many people. And they occupied the promised land. Today, it's just opposite. The promised land belonged to the sons of Isaac. But most of them, they are not sons of Isaac. They are the fake created by the temple priest for the sake of money, cheating people. And that's why Angel Stephen went to the Sanhedrin and told them that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Do not make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision, which is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Nobody else can have it. I lived in Ghana for 14 years. Over there people have tribal marks on their faces. And nobody else can have that tribal mark except that born in that tribe. And they live like brethren. Different tribes, no fighting. If you give them something to eat, then he would call everyone, come, come, let's share. My mother used to be a lecturer there in the University of Science and Technology, Kumasi. And the people used to come, cut the grass. And one day my mother gave a cup of tea to one of them. He won't take it alone. He called everyone, come. All had a sip out of that one. When mother saw this one, the unity, she was surprised. Next time she made a cup for everyone. And they were happy-going people. So this this land is for the tribal people and not for Jew, Hindu, Sikh or Muslim or Christian. So these temple priests, they were making them Jew outwardly of appearance and not of inwardly of heart, spiritual. That's why St. Paul said, a Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual and not outwardly of appearance. So they were making them of appearance, fake sons of Isaac. And they have no right to live there. Remember when first son of Abraham was Ishmael. And when Ishmael was born, he stayed there. But when out of Sarah, the real wife, the real son was born, then Abraham took Hagar and her son Ishmael and put them outside the boundary of the promised land, that you don't have any right to inherit this land. And today, do you think these fake sons of Abraham through circumcision, the Jew of appearance, who are white and Negro, not of Semitic race, do they have right to occupy the promised land? No way. So today, the Jew, they were created by the temple priest of appearance. and not of heart, spiritual. They are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is being fulfilled. There was a chance for me to attend a seminar by this Lord Sikh, that very chief priest, chief rabbi of Britain. And I told him that a Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual, not outwardly, and not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. So to my question, he replied, a Jew is both spiritual and physical. Physical means this one. So I was surprised with his knowledge, but none of the university professors was surprised, because they are dead in the letters. So that's why the good news of the birth of Jesus was broken to the shepherds who were illiterate, who could think themselves or intuition, and not to the university professors in Jerusalem who were his enemy. And so are these Oxford University people. When I tell them the real things, that Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly, and they don't like me, and they kick me out of the seminars and other things. So gospel is not for them. Gospel is for the common man, illiterate, farmers, who have the clean heart and yearning for God. Those people who are not yearning for God, they can't get it. As you can see, how many people are concerned with God. You talk religion, they close their ears, or they will tell you, hey, get lost, don't talk religion here. So they don't want to listen to this thing. So never mind, let me read what I have written. Now this promised land belongs to Abraham and his faithful sons, who can build their covenant with his real naughty son Isaac. So Isaac was circumcised, not Ishmael. But today even the people of Ishmael are being circumcised, which is wrong. The nature of the sons of Isaac was defined by Christ Jesus in John 8 verse 44, that they are liars, murderers, and super bastards, which in my language we call them Shankar Varniyae. This knowledge is universal. So I will apply, we have knowledge in India into Christianity. So don't be worried, you know. So Shankar Varniyae are the super bastards who have renounced their tribal father. Super bastard, fanatic devils, to which the Jews retorted that we are born of legitimate parents. Jesus agreed with them that they were born of legitimate parents, as in India in 1947, people became religious, fanatic devils of appearances, outwardly. Outwardly, turban and beard make them a Sikh and Muslim and all that, you know, appearance. And not spiritual inwardly, as my father was. And frantically kill each other. They were killing babies, old men, all that one, putting their head on spears. So what you see in Israel today, same thing happened in India too. My late father knew this fact. but the people don't listen, did not listen to him. As today, it is the same thing. So people did not, you used to tell people, you know, don't change your tribal identity with Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. That is your spiritual self, not physical self. But they won't listen to him. They were so fanatic in the name of religion, people are very much excited. And you can see it today even. My father explained to him, the man who was attacking our village, that the tribal people, Jatt, Arian, Khatri, etc. are born, and the tribal people will die, and not the spiritual, inwardly, self, Muslim, Sikh, etc. Sikh, etc. So if we tribal people have any enmity between us, let us settle now. Otherwise, do not do bad deeds. So the headman became our best friend in Allah. So headman told my father, we are friends. Because my uncle was his friend. And we have no enmity between us. And then he told my father, let's go to Lahore, capital of Punjab, to stop this partition. My father said, it's too late. It won't be stopped. And so was his concern, you know. And my father used to write to him after partition. We moved to India side. And he used to write with him, but he said, oh, people are not listening. So it's useless. And told his 2,000 supporters to look after us as their guest in Allah, which they did. The same magic can work today if the people of Israel and Palestine become the tribal people and not remain unfaithful Jew, Hamas, Fatah, Hezbollah and all that, you know, that cannot build their links to Abraham. And they must die. They must die, you know, they must kill each other. And that is what they are doing today. Abraham was a noble man of God, picked up by Yahweh to settle in the Middle East. As Adam, Sarah as Eve, and Yahweh gave them the promised land as the Garden of Eden. The promised land was lush green to welcome them back from Egypt as faithful sons of Abraham. The parable of the prodigal son Isaac. So the lush green it became. So, I want to stress that those people who are fake sons of Abraham, through circumcision, with the greedy temple priest, the husbandmen of the wine press created, so they are going to kill them today. There are plenty in Iran. Iran is a country of Arian race. They are almost all of them are circumcised. So they are number one enemy of Israel, created by the greedy temple priest. So you can't blame a third person. So that's why Nanak said, you do not blame a third person, you blame yourself that you created. And whatever you created, and so shall you reap. I can tell a lot, but YouTube and Facebook would remove my video and give me a strike. So there is no freedom of speech. Our Father, Elohim, God, Allah, Parbrahm, blesses people according to their conscience or heart, which we call niyat. The abode of Christ Jesus. This is the temple of God. God lives in his temple. He is not in heaven. So those people who say, our Father in heaven, they are spiritually blind. So God blesses everyone in agape, so we hate none and love all. So if you can build your tribal covenant with Abraham, the father of the faithful, then you can live in peace. Otherwise, under Sukkot means those people who are thrown out of the promised land, like the prodigal son was, under Exodus, you will burn and kill each other as fast as the dried wood. Dried wood is called Sukkot, would burn. Choice is yours and not of your super blind rabbi who called Sukkot a festival to enjoy. You are being thrown out of your father's house and they call it festival. When a blind guide rabbi leaves the blind, spiritually blind, they fall into the pit of Holocaust created by the German tribal man, Hitler. So he killed people, you know, because they were unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, sinners. Today, you have the Russian tribal man, Putin, the super Hitler, to kill the blasphemer USA and the West, that Saddam Hussein, a Khatri Jatt of the Punjab, India, had weapon of mass destruction, but none were found by an army major general who runs a ministry in the name of Christ Jesus. This one, you know, I showed you. So they are nice people, you know, kind-hearted, but they are spiritually blind and they seek the praises of men and they are not solitary. Oh, dear. You need to be solitary, you know, to teach gospel. Here you are, this card. You need to be solitary, otherwise you can't preach gospel, you know. People will stop you. And you have to be like, as Jesus said, if you put your hand on to plow, you don't look back, you know. This is the way it is, you know, the gospel. So who runs a ministry in the name of Christ Jesus? That's Tony Blair and Bush are war criminals that should be killed as St. Peter killed the two blasphemers, Ananias and Sapphira. We should be faithful, we should be thankful to the chosen people of Abraham who have made the gospel as simple as ABC. So, I've written an article on nobility of Abraham, which I will enclose in the description. So our Father God blesses everyone, because in God we exercise love called agape, and under agape is unconditional divine love we extend to everyone. That's why we turn other cheek. Somebody hit you, you present the other cheek. But in Moses, if somebody hit you, then you hit him back. And it was the temple of Yahweh, the Heavenly Father of Jesus, Heavenly Father of Jesus, in which they were selling cattle and other things. And that's why Jesus made a whip to throw them out of the temple. So the religious places are for religious discussions and not for selling making it a marketplace. So these churches which you see them today, they are synagogue of Satan. To get rid of these priests, you know, doctor priests, Jesus died on the cross and tore the curtain of the holiest of holies, that you have a direct approach to God. So if you have a direct approach to God, then where do these doctor priests stand? Nowhere. They are antichrist. So if you want to preach gospel, which cannot be written down in ink on paper, they will hate you. They will say, yeah, where it is written? I know the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. I wrote an article on that. Go to the local priest to tell, hey, look, I have, these are the names of those five husbands. He said, ah, it's not written there in the Bible. Where did you find it? So that is the way they were reacting, you know. So our Father blesses everyone, and end time has approached, and it is up to you to go for Christ inside you, or suffer as Christian of the book outside, Christian outside, not of heart. This is temple of God. God lives in his temple. He is not in heaven anymore, alienated. So those people who say prayer is antichrist, because God lives inside you, before the thing comes to your lip, he already knows. So this prayer, they say, in the churches, first of all, is antichrist. Secondly, our Father is not in heaven. Our Father is inside here. If your temple is clean, free of hypocrisy, like of non-familiar, no duplicity, or your heart is like a little child, then God is inside, and then you speak impartially, doing no favors, and then you are speaking the word of God logically. So the end product of logical reasoning is logo, and logo is his word, and his word is face of God. For example, a people of Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, they were born, they died in the Holocaust. And not Jew, which is scripture itself, never born. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. And this is the word of God, and this is the face of God. In Germany, if you say so, that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, they say it is a crime, and they put you in jail. So that is the spirituality. I used to attend a Kirchentag over here, and after Berlin Kirchentag, they were in Dortmund. So I applied for that one, for a private accommodation, and they put me in school with the youngster. They told me to bring my own bedding and own cup and everything, you know. I paid for the everything. Private accommodation. So I told them I'm not interested, because you don't throw pearls before swine. Remember, two men in Gnesaret, they were saint. They were preaching gospel. But the local rabbi told them, hey, hey, lock them in the silence of the graveyard. They locked them with heavy chain, and the chains were getting broken. And they could see it, the miracle. But they were still doing it under Rabbi. Rabbi knew it, that it is a miracle, you know. So Jesus went to redeem two of them. He redeemed them and told them not to throw pearls before swine. After that, they were not preaching gospel there. They went to Philippi and preached gospel there, and to teach the local a lesson that he was throwing pearls before swine, he's drowned 2,000 swine in the lake. Now, Messianic Jew changes version. They say that two men, they had demons in their head. And all that story you see and you read in the Bible is corruption by the Messianic Jew, number one crook in the world. They created these Pope and his angels and his students, not polytheists. And they killed people and made them deaf and dumb. In them is fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The situation became worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.